Hope all you are fine. And yesterday we have finished our chapter number 5, the land and agriculture in Pakistan and South Asia. And we have read about the composition of land in Pakistan, that forests are 5% in Pakistan, poor scrub and wasteland 16%, agriculture land 37%, mountains and deserts 42%, and irrigation in Pakistan, which is a fairly dry country, the rainfall itself not enough to support good agriculture. So the river Indus and its tributaries, we have a wonderful system of irrigation, and we have built a huge dams across deep valleys in north to hold back the water during flood times. The water is released steadily throughout the year to provide a constant supply of water. And also we have read about the tributaries of River Indus, about the Persian wheels, about the tube wells. Yes, from the 18th slide. Question answers. And the forest, that less than 5% of Pakistan is now forest, means less than 5% means 4.8%. And we read about the Kagan Valley, forested slopes in the upper Kagan Valley. Also that the that people used these forests for firewood, for buildings, and also these forests used for the sports equipment, for the cricket bats, for the furniture, paper making, for building. And we also read about the result of water erosion in Chitral. And then we have read deserts and mountains, that 42% of the total land area of Pakistan are deserts, waste and scrub lands. About 16% of Pakistan's of the wasteland and scrub lands. The government is trying to discourage people from wandering with their flocks and herds, especially goats, into agricultural areas. Then we have read farmlands, that farmland for growing crops forms about 37% of Pakistan's land area. And in India, we have read that India is also mainly agricultural country. It's located on the western coast of the Indian Peninsula in a hilly area known as the Western Ghats. Here, it's covered with deciduous forests and mountain forests. Here, we have read about the two rivers, the Ganges and the Yamuna. We read about the coconut trees. And we have saw the chart of India, that in Pakistan only less than 5% are forests, and in India 23% of forests, pasture grassland 4%, arable land 57%, other land desert and mountains like 16%. And we have read about Bangladesh, that the lower eastern Himalayan foothills from the northern part of Bangladesh, the lower part of Bangladesh is a deltic area, as the Ganges well, as Padma, Meghna, Karnaphuli rivers. We have read about the Nepal and Bhutan. I told you about the height of Nepal and Bhutan, that above the sea level 2000 to 3000 meters high. And we have read about Mount Everest, that the height of Mount Everest is 8848 meters, which is situated in Nepal. And we have read that its offspring peaks. The region is popular destination for mountaineers and tourists. Sri Lanka, the pear-shaped island, Sri Lanka is a pear-shaped island, and It's located on southeastern coast of the Indian Peninsula. And the cash crops of Sri Lanka are tea and rubber. And also the plantation here, rice is also a cash crop. Rice is also grown in the low-lying areas of Sri Lanka. Maldives also located on Indian Ocean to the southwest of India and Sri Lanka. And it comprises or contains 1,200 coral islands and only 199 inhabited islands. It is the smallest independent country in Asia. The capital city is Male. So the Maldives height, it's also counted as a lowest country in the world and average height like 1.5 meters above sea level. So this was our chapter number 5. And today we'll do also the question answers of chapter number 5. And you are also seeing on your screens chapter number 5. Yes. Just give me a minute, beta. Yes. The first question, which you are seeing on your screens, the land and agriculture in Pakistan and South Asia. Question number 1. People who use wood for construction and fuel cut down trees without much thought. How does this affect forests? Answer, due to the indiscriminate cutting down of trees for fuel and construction, the forests, which were once natural vegetation for Pakistan, have shrunk in size and are only 5.2% of ground cover. As a result, deforestation and desertification is taking place. The soil is damaged and washed away by rains and floods. Trees, if planted to replace those cut down, take many years to grow and mature. काफी साल लग जाते हैं जब एक दरख्त को वहां से उसकी डिफॉरेस्टेशन हो जाती है, दरख्त कट जाते हैं, तो जाहिर सी बात है वहां पे दोबारा प्लांटेशन की जाए, वो जब दोबारा से बढ़ते हैं तो वो काफी ज्यादा टाइम ले जाते हैं. Why? Question number 2. Why is firewood needed in some parts of Pakistan? What is the government lying to do to solve this problem? Firewood is vital in many rural areas for fuel, cooking and heating, because there is no electricity or gas available. The government is trying to solve this problem through electrification, provision of gas pipeline, education, and creating awareness about the importance of forests and how to preserve them. Next, teacher. Next, please. Yes. Question number 3. If you are seeing on your screens, what is the importance of agriculture for Pakistan? What are the sources of water for agriculture? This is very compulsory question. And this is very important question, that what is the importance of agriculture for Pakistan? What are the sources of water for agriculture? So the answer of this question is, agriculture is the process of cultivation of land or soil for production purpose. And sorry, agriculture plays a very vital role for the economy of Pakistan and its development. So it is the main source of living or income of the major part of the country. Agriculture is important not only for the supply of food, but also for the provision of raw materials for other industries such as textiles, sugar, jute, vegetable oil, and tobacco. Rivers, water stored in dams and barrages, tube wells are the source of water for agriculture. Because the question was, what is the importance of agriculture for Pakistan and what are the sources of water for agriculture? So this is very important question. Question number four, name the major rivers in Pakistan, India and Bangladesh. Means in the three countries, Pakistan, India and Bangladesh. So the answer of question number four, major rivers are given below. For Pakistan, Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Satluj and Bias. These six rivers are of Pakistan, major rivers. For the India, Ganges, Yamuna, Narmada, Mohandi, Godavari and Krishna. These six rivers for India, Ganges, Yamuna, Narmada, Mohandi, Godavari and Krishna. And for the Bangladesh, Padma, Meghna, Brahmaputra and Karnaphuli. This question, that the major rivers in Pakistan, India and Bangladesh, beta, you must learn by heart, because maybe this question will come for MCQs, maybe this question will come for short question, maybe this question will come for the MCQs blanks or short questions. So for the major rivers in Pakistan, Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Satluj, Bias. And for India, Indian rivers, Ganges, Yamuna, Narmada, Mahanadi, Godavari and Krishna. And the Bangladesh rivers, Padma, Meghna, Brahmaputra and Karnaphuli. These four rivers for Bangladesh. Name the highest peak in Sri Lanka. So this is also, maybe this question will also come in MCQs, a short question or blanks, or maybe for the short question. The highest peak in Sri Lanka is Mount Pidratla. So this is the highest peak of Sri Lanka. And number three, name the capitals of Nepal and Bhutan. The capital of Nepal is Kathmandu and the capital of Bhutan is Thimphu. Yes, next teacher, next please. Question number five.
This is question number five.
Sorry?
This is question number five.
Yes. Question number five, beta, it's also on your screens. And beta, you are seeing on your screens. Write few lines on Bhutan, Nepal, Maldives. Answer of this question, Bhutan is a country in South Asia. Its capital is Thimphu. Bhutan is a Buddhist kingdom on the Himalayas eastern edge. Is known for its monasteries, forests, or zongs, not dzongs, D is silent, or zongs and dramatic landscapes that range from subtropical plains to steep mountains and valleys. So this is for Bhutan, and this short question is also included in class 9. Nepal. Nepal is a country in South Asia bordering the Republic of India and the People's Republic of China. Mount Everest, you already know that in Nepal, Mount Everest is located. Mount Everest, the highest mountain in the world, is found there. As well as the Himalaya mountains, 12 of the world's highest mountain peaks are in Nepal. Means, as well as the Himalayan mountains, 12 of the world's highest mountain peaks are in Nepal. Nepal mein, puri duniya mein se jo 12 highest peaks hain, wo Nepal mein. Isliye bhi Nepal ko puri duniya mein jana jata hai. Its capital is Kathmandu. Nepal is famous for the beauties of nature by the soaring peaks of the Himalayas, green valleys, terraced farmlands, hilly foot trails, and the forested plains full of rare wildlife. Maldives. The Maldives, officially the Republic of Maldives, is a small island nation in South Asia, situated in the Arabian Sea of the Indian Ocean. It comprises about 1,200 coral islands spread across the equator, only 199 of which are inhabited. It lies southwest of Sri Lanka and India. Its capital is Male. The Maldives is known for their natural environment, including the blue ocean, white beaches, and clean air. The climate of the Maldives is ideal for visitors to get engaged in water sports such as swimming, fishing, scuba diving, snorkeling, and water skiing. So this is the answer of question number 5. It's a long question, and maybe in exam, they will ask that write few lines on Bhutan and Maldives. Write few lines on Nepal and Bhutan, or Bhutan and Maldives, or Maldives or Bhutan. So this is a long question. Next teacher. Here, if you are seeing on your screens, here we have given a sample short questions. Sample of short questions. What is this meaning? Means sample short questions, because you have already underlined the lines of this chapter. Not only the underlined lines, beta, you must read this chapter thoroughly. And we have given you in front of these questions the pages also. Like the first question, what is the main river of Pakistan? So what is the main river of Pakistan? What should be the answer? Like River Indus. So how much of land is covered with forests in Pakistan? You can say less than 5%. These are only the sample questions. Write down the main cash crop of India. What is the main cash crop of India? You already know. Like wheat, rice, cotton, sugarcane, and tea. Also included jute. What type of climate in Bangladesh? its sorry. Number five, name the world's highest peak in Nepal. I have already told you that which is the highest peak in Nepal. Write down, and when you will write this highest peak of in Nepal, you must write also the height of the Mount Everest. Number six, write down the main cash crops of Sri Lanka. When I was taking recap, I told you about rubber and tea. These are the main cash crops. What natural disaster affected Sri Lanka in December 2004? You must know that what happened in December 2004 in Sri Lanka means tsunami. Maldives is sinking. Give two reasons. At the in the paragraph of Maldives, they have given the reason because the high average height above the sea level. So, and second is global warming. So that means, yes, you are very right. So, beta, you must write, this is also your homework, that you must write these all question answers, all six question answers, sorry, five question answers on your NEET copies, and also the sample short questions you must write in your NEET copy and answer. You will search from your book and you have to write down on your NEET copies and learn by heart also. This is your homework. And we have finished our chapter. We have finished our question answers. And these are the sample short question answers. If you have any question about this chapter, write it in the chat box. If you have any question. Write it in the chat box about this chapter. Because today we have finished our this chapter, the land and agriculture in Pakistan and South Asia. We have done our question answers and also sample short question answers. You must write it in your NEET copies. Any question, beta? Is it clear? Is it clear, beta? Okay. That means it's clear. Yes, teacher.